We want to simplify the given expressions. Here we have 6x to the 4th y to the 0 times 4x to the 0. Well, anything raised to the 0 power is equal to 1, so we can rewrite this as 6x to the 4th, again, since y to the 0 is equal to 1, times, this would just be 4, since x to the 0 is equal to 1. And since 6 times 4 is equal to 24, this simplifies to a 24x to the 4th. Looking at our second example, we do want to try to simplify inside the parentheses first. So this would be x to the 1st, y to the 2nd, z to the 6th. Then we have x to the 5th, y to the 6th, z to the 4th in the denominator. And since we're dividing, when the bases are the same, we're going to be subtracting the exponents. So the 2/3 is not going to simplify. And then we have x to the power of 1 minus 5, that's going to be x to the negative 4th. Y to the power of 2 minus 6, that's going to be y to the negative 4th. And then for z to the 6th divided by z to the 4th, we'll have z to the power of 6 minus 4, that's z to the 2nd. And all this is being raised to the power of negative 2. So again, we can think of this as 2 to the 1st and 3 to the 1st. So we have powers raised to powers, so we're going to multiply every exponent by negative 2. So we'll have 2 to the negative 2 over 3 to the negative 2, x to the power of negative 4 times negative 2, that's positive 8, y to the power of negative 4 times negative 2, that's y to the positive 8th. And then we have z to the power of 2 times negative 2, that's z to the negative 4th. And now let's deal with the negative exponents. So we're going to move 2 to the negative 2 to the denominator. We're going to move 3 to the negative 2 up into the numerator. So we'll have 3 to the 2nd, or 9, in the numerator, and 2 to the 2nd in the denominator, which is 4. And then for the variable factors, remember, we can think of this as being in fraction form with a denominator of 1. So the x to the 8th, y to the 8th would be in the numerator. And then we'll move z to the negative 4th into the denominator, which will be z to the power of positive 4. And now this expression is simplified. For the last example, this would be x to the 4th, y to the 1st, raised to the 5th. And this would be x to the 2nd, y to the 1st, raised to the negative 3rd. So in the numerator, we're going to multiply the exponents. So we'll have x to the power of 4 times 5, that's 20. Y to the power of 1 times 5, that's 5. Times, here we'll have x to the power of 2 times negative 3, that's x to the negative 6th. And then y to the power of 1 times negative 3, that's negative 3. All over x to the 7th, y to the 6th. And now we're going to continue multiplying in the numerator. We have x to the 20th times x to the negative 6th. We're going to add the exponents. That's going to be x to the 14th. And then we'll have y to the power of 5 plus negative 3. That's positive 2. Our denominator stays x to the 7th, y to the 6th. Now because we're dividing, we'll be subtracting the exponents. So we'll have x to the power of 14 minus 7, that's x to the 7th. And then y to the power of 2 minus 6, that's y to the negative 4th. And then for the last step, we'll have to move y to the negative 4th to the denominator. And we'll have x to the 7th over y to the 4th. Okay, I hope you found this helpful.